Good morning, everyone. So today we have with us Shri N.K. Tripathi, Vice Chancellor, Malvanchal University. Sir has done his MBA in marketing from DAVD Indore. He has had an exceptional career. He is a retired IPS officer and has held important positions in Home Department, Intelligence, Administration, and CID, marking a mark everywhere, and has been awarded different medals, including President's Police Medal. He also believes in giving back to the society and is associated with an NGO called Umang in Gwalior. The NGO is providing free medical consultancy and medicines in slum areas predominantly inhabited by minority. That's such an inspiring story, sir. So, to start with the interview, for the first question, we would like to know, do you have any extracurricular activities, programs to enhance the skills of students or expose them to the real world challenges in your college?
Yeah, of course. I mean, in Malvanchal University, we lay a lot of stress and emphasis on the extracurricular activities. And therefore, because every university, every college is providing the curriculum to the students in the manner it is provided, but it is only the extracurricular activities which matter. We always take our students, because we have mostly the medical health related subjects, so we take them to the nearby villages, interact with people, know about their problems, and that is how they learn. This is one of the extracurricular activities we lay emphasis on. And secondly, apart from sports and cultural, all those extracurricular activities are there in a way. And of course, we encourage, especially our cultural events are very, very, very well organized and people appreciate it. Apart from these extracurricular, activities, what I have mentioned, we also try to inculcate extra skills also, which are not in the curriculum. So you can also call them extracurricular activities, though they are also part of the teaching, but they are not part of the curriculum. So skill development, in a way, is also one of our extracurricular activities. So our university is all the time busy in extracurricular activities, including students and the faculty.
So, sir, when you came to the college, you had such a great experience of working in different zones and different states. So what was your vision and how are you trying to achieve the same?
You see, as far as the vision is concerned, our vision right from the beginning is not simply to impart teaching to the students. It was always to develop the personality of the student. We want that any student who goes out of my campus must be a person to look at. Not only that, he is only academically very good. That doesn't mean, because acquiring the knowledge of your own profession doesn't matter much. But our vision is to inculcate that extra thing which comes out from the student. In a way, as you know, every individual in education has its own goal.
Yes.
And it is the inner drum beats of the student. We try to get it out. And that is our vision. Once he knows his own drum beats, the sky is the limit for him. We, of course, give him the best possible education, but with these things of his developed personality, he is definitely a different person than what he was before he joined our campus.
So like you told us that you take students to slum areas for training and stuff. So are there anything else, like what are the invention and approaches that you bring in the curriculum to help them train, you know?
See, we take them not only to the slum, but to the villages in the rural area, which are nearby. Our university is also situated in rural area. Of course, we do visit slums also, and our university students have very successfully led anti-TB operation in slums of Indore. And especially the child who were suffering from TB, and we have cured as many children as we took them, adopted them. So it was a big achievement for us. But as far as the villages are concerned, we do take our students to there. And you are asking what innovation they can think about it.
Mm-hmm.
The moment they go out, ideas generate into their mind. Suppose he is studying in dental science. Mm-hmm. But once he goes to the village and asks the people what are the problems he is facing regarding the dental health, then he comes to know certain things which are not there in his curriculum. And then he tries to develop that skill, innovation. Another innovation is a group discussions among themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And participative education. That is another, I mean, because it's not just imparting one way in the class by the teacher to the student. That's not my concept of teaching. The teaching has to be participative, in which the students are very much part of the teaching and learning process. So our teaching and learning process itself is an innovation, and definitely we are in the process of inculcating these feelings. And what you ask is the innovation that is here.
Also, sir, as we know that, you know, in medical science and in the doctors, they always have to be on the field. So it's really important to be, you know, have a practical approach towards everything. So how do you try to bring in that practical approach towards subjects and make them ready for, you know, going out in the field and doing their job?
Partly, I have already replied to you in my earlier answers.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, we interact with people.
Mm-hmm.
Because medical sciences or health sciences, even nursing or even pharma or paramedical, they are all concerned with human beings.
Mm-hmm.
Unlike engineers who deal only with material, here are the people who have to interact with human beings. So first of all, they should be able to communicate.
Mm-hmm.
And communication means he should also be able to listen what others say. That is to understand what others say. What you are saying, that how we train these people in our practical approach. The practical approach comes when they visit people, they discuss their problem, and then they come back in their laboratories or in their classrooms, try to relate with that. And there comes the importance of the seminars on also interdiscipline approach. A nursing student should know something about the doctor. The doctor should know something about the pharma. So interacting with different faculties is also one of the way to make them more practical. So this is how we, and being participative education, as I told you, it makes more and more practical. For example, suddenly there was Corona. This COVID-19 disease. Our university, our hospital, was also one of the chosen hospitals by the government where COVID patients in hundreds were coming and we were treating them. It was a practical exposure. It was not in their textbooks. This disease is not curable, at least by the medicines we know. So, but how to treat their symptoms, how to adapt oneself to the new situation, to new pandemic, all these practical things they are exposed, probably the best time they had with this exposure. Of course, this was a tragedy, but the tragedy is also an opportunity. And mind it is not the first pandemic. At least you are a young person, you will see many more in your life in many different ways. So we are training our students to face any unseen situations in future. Not only our doctors, but all paramedical and nursing staff. And that will be a big achievement, what Malvanchal University will provide to the society.
So you have already answered my next question, that anything that your university does that you would like other people to know. So, so having all these things said, so is, you know, what you, from your experience, what would be a valuable advice that you would like to give students or the current youth to have a aspiring students of medical to have a prosperous career in the field?
See, first of all, they should be sound in their professional knowledge. That is the beginning point, but not the end. That is simply the beginning point. that they should be very strong in their own professional skills and professional studies. That is number one. Number two, throughout the period they are there in the campus, from first year, second year, etc., we inculcate a feeling that they should not go in for rote learning, that is cramming the things and just vomiting it out in the examination, which is what unfortunately the Indian system is, because we always judge a student in examination not by his skill, not by his intelligence, but by his power to memorize things and throw it in the examination. We are testing only that part. So we are trying to tailor-made our examination also in that manner, where we try to develop this initiative on part of the students. So instead of rote learning, we advise our students to go in for critical learning. Critical learning means analyzing the thing, understanding it, questioning it, and then absorbing into their mind. This critical learning. With this critical learning, they should go out in the world of, I mean, actual work, and there they will never fail, because this knowledge which they have gained through critical learning will always make them separate from the rote learners, those who are just, I mean, learning. And this is also one of the vision of my university, that we should eliminate rote learning, this, I mean, use a coaching institute type of study, and go in for critical teaching and learning.
So as you mentioned critical learning, I'm assuming that it is one of the greatest strengths of your department or your college. So would you like to let us know other some strengths which are your, you know, USP of the college, and how you are trying to enhance those strengths?
You see, our management is very sensitive to society. What I told you, how a student is taught in my university, what are the extracurricular thing he can do or he is supposed to do, and not only suppose, he is doing it in our campus. That is another part. The method they should learn. These are the strength of my university. Apart from this, we try to make him a good human being. This approach is the final end of our strength, that anyone who goes out of my university is a very nice gentleman and a good human being, always having empathy to the society. And I think if we are able to achieve this, nothing else is required in the university life. Even the best of the universities are only trying for it. And Malvanchal University, though it's a very new university, you will find after some time when our students are going out more in numbers, that it will make a dent into the educational field.
Thank you so much, sir, for being associated with us for the program Thoughts of Education by College Duniya. It has been a really great experience. You have shared a lot of things. So the insights were really helpful. Would you like to share something or say something on the ending note to all the viewers that who would be watching this video?
To the viewers, I will say that if they get any opportunity, if they are young people, if they are aspiring people, students, young students who want to graduate into these health-related subjects, they should come to our university. The senior people, they can send their words, they can inspire them to come to us, and definitely they will be benefited by it. That much I can assure.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words.
Thank you.